Sri Lanka is not the only country which the president and the prime minister does not see eye to eye. Certainly, I think they have a working relationship. The defense the minister of this country is the sole person who's responsible for the security of the country, and by constitution that is the president. Whether it's A, B or C, I'm not concerned about that. I'm just laying out the constitutional framework. The prime minister also has not attended, has not been called to attend the Security Council meetings also. So I think...
I think there
was a lack of professionalism in that approach. I think whoever is the prime minister should by convention come to the security and be invited to come to the Security Council meetings. So I think those are huge lapses which we have to assess. Sri Lanka is not the only country which has faced this, but the jihadists seem to be targeting our country as a retribution to what happened in New Zealand. So why they picked Sri Lanka? Maybe because there was this jihadist movement here, which was active. It was active cell for the last 5-6 years. It was active cell. So the Indians and other foreign agencies also told us about this threat. But unfortunately, we did not take the necessary precautions to move against them.
Is this a one-off attack, Minister? Or do you think that Sri Lanka is facing a cycle of violence, a campaign of violence aimed at inflaming religious tensions?
Inflaming religious tension is part of this movement's objectives. What we as a government and as a responsible people have to do now, or even our government or any future government, to make sure that this jihadist movement does not spread. And I think it won't spread, because the vast majority of Muslims in our country do not want this kind of violence. So it is like you mentioned, it's a minority that is doing this. We have to go hard after them. There is no question about it. And we have the wherewithal, the resources, whether it's soft power or hard power, we have that. Our security forces have that capacity to go after them and take them out. So we have to do that within the law.
Hi, I'm Emily Tan, and thanks for watching CNBC. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.